Sleep is really important for aging as well, particularly the aging brain, you know. So, in fact, I was wearing a continuous glucose monitor. I've been wearing one for a few months now. And my son, like around Thanksgiving time, started having teething and stuff. And he started waking up in the middle of the night and he'd be up for like an hour. And it was like, so I was basically having very fragmented sleep. And my blood glucose levels, like my fasting blood glucose levels and my postprandial, were like 15 to 20 units higher. And this was like repeatable. I was, you know, my diet's pretty much, I, you know, eat the same thing. So it's not, I wasn't like eating anything like a cookie or anything like that. I mean, it was just like, and doing some high intensity interval training did help. And there actually is some research on that. But I was astounded by the effect sleep had, or lack of sleep.
Yeah, if you take a rat and deprive it of sleep, it'll get diabetes within a matter of a month or so.
I mean, it's just like, it was, it, you know, I had read the studies. I had Dr. Matt Walker on the podcast, talked all about it. But when it happens to yourself and you see the data, I mean, of course, it's still just an N of one for me. But I mean, it was just like, it was very, to me, it made it very real. I was like, this really is regulating my insulin level, my insulin
Yeah,
sensitivity.
right. I could see my age changing when I had young kids.
Oh, absolutely. I've aged for sure. I mean, you can see it. Like, the you know, especially as a nursing mother, and you're in the early, you know, days of my son being born, it was just so hard. I mean, it was so
Yeah,
hard.
just check out photos of me in my 30s and early 40s when it was lack of sleep and stress and my wife screaming at me for traveling, that kind of stuff. That wore me out. You can see that I aged rapidly. Since then, I don't think, and others don't think, that I've aged much since then. So it's sleep and stress,
Yeah,
all
important.
important.